Hey everyone, today I want to show you how you could take an iPhone and reset it to factory default, basically making it a brand new phone. So if you're selling your phone or if you want to give your phone to someone else, maybe you've upgraded your phone, this is what you got to do to reset it to factory default, making it a brand new phone. In this case, I'm using an iPhone 6S, but if you have an iPhone X, really any iPhone, the process is pretty much the same. So let me jump into the phone and show you how to do it. I'll show you a quick way on how you could back up your phone in this video too. This is using iCloud, just a real quick way to make sure once you reset it, you don't lose any information. Because when you reset it, your photos go away, your apps go away, it becomes a brand new phone. So everything needs to be backed up. Let's jump into the phone and take a look. So we're in the phone here, and the first thing we want to do is go to settings, and we want to check to make sure we have the latest backup. So if you haven't backed it up, it's okay, we could do that here, but make sure we have the latest backup before we erase this phone. Now we want to go to iCloud, and in iOS 10 or before, it used to be down here somewhere. Here you should see iCloud, but in iOS 11 and so on, it's over here. So if I click here, I want to look for iCloud, which in this case is in the middle of the screen. Down here, it has all my iOS devices here, so I could also get to it there. But let me show you how you get to iCloud from here. Go to iCloud, and we want iCloud backup. So if we scroll down, we should see iCloud backup right here. Click that, and mine has been turned on because I've been doing it. I've been doing backups all the time. So if yours is not, go ahead and turn it on. And right here on the bottom, it shows you the date. So in this case, this is the date of my last backup. But if you have not backed it up recently, or this is not recent, just go ahead and press backup and it'll start creating that backup for you. Again, this could take a bit of time. This is a 64 gig iPhone, so this is gonna take a bit of time. But again, you will erase your entire phone, so make sure you have the latest backup. This is what we're gonna also use if you wanna set up a new device from this backup. And just one more note here, I've actually upgraded my iCloud to be 50 gigs. It's only 99 cents to do that. So just in case you get an error message here or you need more space, you'll have to upgrade your iCloud, or you could use iTunes. In iTunes, you simply plug in your phone and back up your phone into your computer. I recommend getting the 99 cent iCloud storage upgrade. Otherwise, it's only backing up 5 gigs worth of your iPhone data. And for 99 cents a month, you get 50 gigs. So that's what I have. That's why I didn't get an error message when I tried this. While this backup is going on, make sure you're plugged in to power and you have Wi-Fi. So I have Wi-Fi, I'm plugged into power. You could also remove your SIM card. If you're giving this phone away, or if you're selling it, you could just remove your SIM card. Your new phone will probably come with a SIM card already, so you don't need your old SIM card. But it's a good option to remove your SIM card. Again, doing this backup, this erase, doesn't affect the SIM card, but I don't like giving away with my phone with the SIM card in it. I'm gonna let this backup complete, and as soon as it's done, I'll jump back and show you how to wipe the phone. Okay, once the backup is complete, you could come back into the previous page, and these are the things it backed up. So as you could see, Apple using iCloud, photo, and all these things that are turned on, it's backing up. If you didn't want to back any of these up, you could simply turn them off when you did your backup. In this case, I left everything on, your iMessages, your photos, everything that you have through iTunes will be in iTunes, so you will have to get them from iTunes once this is complete, like your music or movies. But this does back up everything that's on the phone. The very next step is turning off Find My iPhone. This is gonna ask you to do it later, so you might as well do it right now since we're on this page. Go ahead and click Find My iPhone and just go ahead and turn it off. Most of the times it's gonna ask you to enter your password, so go ahead and enter your password. And there you go. Now we've turned off Find My iPhone. Now we wanna go back and then go back again. And now we want to go back to General. So let's click that. And then let's scroll all the way to the bottom. You should see a reset option. So now if you press reset, just like that on the bottom of the page. So on this page, we wanna press erase all content and settings. That's the second option. That's gonna set our phone to factory default. So again, make sure that's what you wanna be doing. And then let's press that. It's asking you to backup then erase. So we already did the backup process. So if you see this, make sure you've already backed up. I've already backed up, so I don't need to do this, but if you haven't, you could do this here, backup then erase. In this case, I'll just do erase now. I'm just gonna type in my passcode here. And it's going to ask me one more time. This will delete all media and data. Yes. And then it's going to ask me one last time just to make sure I want to do this. I'm going to say yes. And there you go. It's going to start deleting everything on this phone and setting it as a factory default iPhone. So I'll come back when this is complete. So that took about 5 minutes. I had about 35 gigs worth of information on that phone. So not very much, not very long to go ahead and reset that phone. And now you have a brand new iPhone here with no information on it. So now if you want to give this to someone else, I wouldn't go past this step. I would just leave this as is. And then you could just go ahead and turn it off. Just hold the side button to turn it off, and then you could sell it or give it to someone else. I hope this video was helpful. If you're doing this to set up for a new device, there is a link in the description to that video. Please come back to see a lot more tech-related videos on this channel, and I hope to see you on the next video. Thanks so much for watching.